why does huge matter? Why does it matter to me? Especially since I haven't seen the show. That's a question that a lot of people have asked me. And it's because I've kept up with the show on fashionista.com. Leslie Kinzel has a great update of the show. So I know what's going on. I just don't have time for the show. I just don't have time to watch TV in general. So why would I be interested in saving the show Huge? And why does Huge matter to me? Well, for one thing, it's just nice to have a show on TV that the people look like me, or you, or pretty much anyone. And some people don't appreciate that. We hear complaints from them all the time, but you know what? We don't give a shit. There is a power in representation. There's comfort in seeing people like you represented. It seems natural that we would be pushing for greater representation on TV, because with greater representation, people will stop treating us like crap, because we will no longer be seen as freaks. Television helps reduce that temptation in people to gawk and stare. If you want to gawk and stare, you can, you know, watch a TV show about fat people, and that'll do you some good. So, but I think more importantly is that there have been lots of shows that feature fat people. The most obvious example being Tom and Roseanne on The Roseanne Show, otherwise known as Roseanne. that show was definitely the forerunner of Huge, really. It was the mother of Huge, so to speak, where, you know, the characters, their weight really wasn't the central issue of the show. It was just a show about this middle-class family, lower middle-class family, that also happened to be fat. The mom and dad happened to be fat. And Huge, I think, ironically, is like that. I mean, it's about fat camp, and it's, you know, the entire cast is almost entirely fat people, but the show isn't really about their weight, and it's not about them losing weight. The more important, the more engaging part of the show is the love story between Will and Ian. When the show first came out, people were really concerned that this show wasn't going to take the issue seriously, and that people would just be caricatures, and it wouldn't be, it wouldn't be an honest show. And which is kind of silly, considering that Winnie Holzman and Savannah Dooley were working on it. Knowing that it was in their hands, you knew that it would be treated with the dignity and respect that we would hope that it would have, and it did. If a show like Mike and Molly were canceled, I don't think this would be as big an issue. I don't think, I mean, no offense to Melissa McCarthy or the other guy, but I don't think that show really matters in the grand scheme of things. It's like a sitcom. And there are lots of sitcoms with, fat men, very few with fat women, in fact, none that I can think of, which is a problem in and of itself. There are funny women, but how many funny fat women really get their own shows except Melissa McCarthy? But I would hope that she would get a show where part of the humor weren't cheap shots at fat people. You know, that she would get a show that where, like Gilmore Girls, where she was treated with respect and just like a person. I want to get to the point in this culture where a little girl does not have to feel self-conscious about her body because it's shaped differently than what they're told it's supposed to be shaped like. So I don't want, if my little girls are going to grow up in this world, I don't want them to be pressured to look differently than nature had intended them to. And that's why fat acceptance is important to me, and that's why Huge is important to me, is that Huge helps change the way society looks at fat people and treats fat people. And also, it helps fat people think about themselves differently and treat themselves differently. You know, to see Will with so much confidence and chutzpah and, the stripping scene, I had to watch that happen. If you want to see a second season of Huge, letters aren't going to do it. Fans write letters for canceled shows all the time. The television industry in the past has proven that sometimes does not have our best intentions at heart. as viewers. But there are shows that actually have an impact on our society and have an impact on people that should be kept around, that even if they're not profitable, they deserve to live, if only to enrich our culture. Okay, a good example is Arrested Development. You know, 2 seasons and they were ready to cancel it. You know, they brought it back for a 3rd season. Why? Because fans spoke up and said, no, this show is too good to let go. Even my beloved show, Mystery Science Theater, was canceled by Comedy Central because it wasn't profitable anymore. You know, they ran 7 seasons and they canceled it. And, you know, Comedy Central had no intention of bringing it back, but the fans rallied behind it. So I think that we can save Huge. We most definitely can save Huge. But what it's going to take is energy. It's going to take coordination, and it's going to take you. There's 1.35 million people watching Huge at the end. 1.35 million people who did not get to see how it ended, who did not get to see whether Will and Ian get back together. And I know 1.35 million people aren't going to, you know, do jack crap for the show. But, you know, 10% of them? What's 10% of them? Like 1,500 people? If 1% of the people, of 1.35 million people, decided that this show is worth saving, I think ABC would listen. That's the point of these videos. One is first and foremost, is to tell the network why Huge matters, why it matters to you, why the show is more than just a show, why it's a show that people need and want and will do just about anything to save, you know, that these characters have resonated with us, that these situations and the stories that are unique to fat people mean something to us, that maybe they don't see it, but we do, and we need it to continue. Okay, here's what I need you to do. I need you to make a video explaining why Huge matters to you. Explain it however you choose. You know, if you've painted something about Huge, if you've written a poem about Huge, if you've done choreographed an interpretive dance about Huge, if you've chiseled an ice sculpture of Huge, if you have hostages in your basement that you're holding until they renew Huge. Most important, we need you to join us.
Out here, in the streets, in front of ABC Studios.
On November 13th, it's a Saturday, so from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. in your city, outside the ABC Studios of your choice. We've got people in New York, Chicago, Los Angeles, Hollywood, San Francisco, Boston. All cities are going to be represented here. Minneapolis. Gotta love Minneapolis. We're going to celebrate Huge like nobody's ever celebrated a television show before. We had 1 season, but it was a great season. And we're also going to be asking ABC to reconsider. Maybe they will, maybe they won't. Who knows? But we're going to ask. We can also ask networks to consider making another show. Maybe a cheaper show. You know, a show that's a sitcom about fat people, but one that doesn't dehumanize them or treat them like the butt of jokes. A show that treats them like human beings. I think they're capable of doing that. Who knows? Who knows what can happen? But I do know that if we don't do anything, then we're going to get nothing but more Joey Lawrence sitcoms. And I don't know about you, but I can only take so much. Whoa! The charm is limited for me. So, join us November 13th, 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. We'll be making signs, we'll be dancing, we'll be possibly nude, who knows? But we're taking to the streets, and we need you to join us. So do it. Join us November 13th. Visit us at fiercefatties.com to find out more. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you so much for making your own videotapes. And I'll see you on November 13th when we try to save Huge. The finger of doom points at you. Join us. Or be